We have an incredible paper today. I mean, look at this. This paper is fire. Yes, scientists were able to build a super detailed computer simulation of wildfires. So, what can it do? Well, it can show us what a fire in a savanna looks like. And I wonder, how is it different from a tropical rainforest? And how does the moisture content of the grass change the fires? And, oh yes, we will also see my favorite, that is, how close a simulation can get to reality and so much more. Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai Fehér. So, there is a huge problem with these wildfires. What is the problem? Well, the problem is that in many cases, these fires cannot be contained, because everything you see here is fuel. Grass, wood, decomposing organic material, everything. These fires are uncontrolled and often unpredictable. Very destructive, too. One bushfire season in Australia has caused 1 billion animals to perish. That is terrible. But this paper finally gives us a way to do something about it. Maybe. Because, get this, it can simulate the more fortunate cases where we can avoid the chaos, specifically when the fire is confined to the forest floor only. But now, things get worse, a lot worse, and that is when a fiery inferno can break out. They call this a crown fire, and this is when the trees also start to burn. In the worst case, the whole biomass burns down. It also takes into consideration the kinds of trees there are in the forest and how dry they are, which is incredible. But it gets a ton more detailed from here. It also takes into consideration if the biomass in the forest has unequal height, which is often the case for an uncultivated forest. But get this, it also shows good news and the virtues of vegetation management and how it can potentially prevent a crown fire. Now, after seeing all this, you, wise fellow scholars, already know that if we see a savanna like this, a wildfire here is going to behave really differently. The grass catches fire immediately, then goes to the shrubs. Not a lot of vapor here. Now, look, if the same happens in a tropical rainforest, look at that! They even simulated the vapor. This will help the taller trees avoid the fire. I had to hold on to my papers not to fall off the chair when seeing this kind of quality. Incredible. But it gets even better. It also takes into consideration the moisture content of the grass and reacts accordingly. And now comes the worst part. Embers. Oh yes, embers can be carried away by the wind at speeds faster than a car on the highway, and they ignite new fires wherever they land, making the wildfire even more chaotic and unpredictable. Okay, so here is our big question. These fires are uncontrolled and often unpredictable. So, can this paper predict the unpredictable? Now, hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, because here is a real burn experiment. And now, look, the simulation. Oh my goodness, that is an incredibly close match. And that is going to be a huge game changer. Why? Because it might help us predict potential wildfire situations in real areas. Just use them as an input and see what would happen in reality. And while we look at the unfortunate demise of this beautiful forest, we can learn a ton, not just from the footage, but they even published how they have done it in a research paper. And they give it all away to all of us for free. That is the power of research. Thank you so much. It is a beautifully written computer graphics paper. You simply got to have a look. It is next level. No AI is being used here, only pure human ingenuity and beauty like you've never seen in a paper before. And it also has more details than I just said. Win-win! Check it out in the video description. With this, we can explore these situations safely in a computer simulation where no one gets hurt, and we get to learn what we can do to minimize the damage. Absolutely incredible! What a time to be alive! So, what do you think? What would you fellow scholars use this for? Let me know in the comments below, plus subscribe and hit the bell, because we talk about works that nobody is talking about. And, let's be honest, we all need more amazing amazing papers in our lives. To run your own experiments on an NVIDIA GPU, check out Lambda. I use it myself regularly for these videos. Look at that! You can generate high-quality images in less than a second per image. I did a ton more of them and paid less than a dollar for all this. Crazy! Seriously, try it out now at lambdalabs.com/papers or click the link in the description.